Hello, welcome to my Bliss. In this video, we are talking about parrots. Specifically, I had a question about parrotlets and taming them. Hi, I'm Kaylin, the author of the Parrot Bliss Bond, and I'm starting to design my parrot stock because I like parrot t-shirts, and actually, there it was me. My daughter made this one, dreaming of conure, golden conure kisses. And if you follow my channel, you know I am dreaming of having a golden conure. And I think it's lining up. In this video, I have Olivia and Anya and maybe Carlos. Maybe we'll try to keep it to three babies. Come here, Carlos. Oh, and there goes Anya. We're talking about taming parrotlets, but this applies to really all parrots. So the whole point to hand feeding a parrot is that they are going to be more used to people and more tame. So I don't know the research, but basically I think the research says that when a parrot is about, well, at the age where they're opening their eyes, one of the things that happens is they then like imprint on their parents, and they will be nice to, or you know, be comfortable with their parents. Ooh, that hurt. There you go, bite my ring, not me. And so people can feed them so that the parrots recognize people and are comfortable with people. They're happy, they're part of the flock, there's a bond because they were fed by people. Oh, I've got juveniles here. These guys are all a couple months old. What are you? 2.5 months old, 3 months old? And they are going through their biting phase. Just like puppies that bite everything. Parrotlets, and I think all parrots, they go through a nibbling on my fingers phase, and it doesn't feel good. They do outgrow it, and they get more gentle, so you have to be kind of patient with them. So that is why they get hand-fed, and the idea is, therefore, they will make a sweeter pet. However, one advantage to getting a parrot straight from a breeder is that, number one, they are going from their home with their germs and like the flora, the bacteria that they're used to a new one in your home, and there's only one change. The other advantage is that if the breeder has hand-fed them, they're gonna go from being handled every day to you, and you're probably going to handle your pet every day. Hi. Oh my. I gotta see where they go. Now, the advantage to a pet store, the advantage to getting your parrotlet in a pet store is that they are available all the time, so you can go and you usually have a nice variety of choices as far as breeds go, and as far as even within one breed, like different color parrotlets, maybe different genders, all sorts of things like that. The disadvantage is that sometimes parrots are sold before they're hand weaned, sometimes parrots are sold before they even make it in the store, and other times parrots sit in the store for a little while, and it can even be months. While they're sitting in the store for months, if they aren't being handled every day, which can happen, they can lose their connection to people and they can kind of get untamed. Now, they're not gonna be as untamed as if they hadn't been hand fed, but they can get less tamed. So, if you have that kind of situation, because the person that wrote me said that they got their parrotlet from a store, 5 months old, but not really tamed. You know, the parrotlet probably was pretty tame at some point. But now what you want to do, and this is true for a lot of parrots, is you really want to spend a lot of time with your parrot. We don't like clipping our parrots. I pay the price because my macaws fly around and eat everything. It's got pros and cons. But for my husband and I, we really feel like a parrot got to fly. They, you know, it's just a big part of them. And if we need to, like I clipped her when I took her on a trip because I did not trust that she wouldn't get out of her cage at some point. And I was right. So I probably would have lost a couple of parrotlets, she and her brother, if I hadn't clipped. When I have to clip for their health and safety or for another parrot's health and safety, I will. But otherwise, we don't like these. One exception I make, though, is if I'm really trying to tame a parrot. If you tame a parrot and you clip them, what happens is they're gonna have to stay with you. So basically, you saw these guys fly away. And of course, if you brought your parrotlet home, it's staying in its cage where it feels safe, which is great, it's gonna take a long time to come around. I have Pico, my Amazon, who I got as an adult. He's never been too tame. And we've had him for a couple of years and he now lets me pet him, but it's just not much interaction, it's very slow. So, to get past the emotional charge, the fear charge, more quickly, when I'm taming, I will clip their wings and I will leave them either really close by me for hours, 6 hours during the day, or on my shoulder. And that is because within a day, they're going to start to figure out, or less, you know, that I'm not so bad, that hanging out with me is not so bad. I believe in being a Pez seed dispenser, and that means just like the old Pez toys, remember the candy dispensers? Instead of putting sunflower seeds in cages, I give them. It makes me special, it gives them something special to come to for me. It gives us something to bond about. I don't just put them in their cages, because it's like empty calories as far as I'm concerned. I don't like feeding my parrots and having them still be hungry, which is what was happening. So, I'm the pest dispenser, and therefore, when they're spending 6 hours a day by my side or with me and on me, I'm not necessarily engaging the whole time. Just like I'm doing the video, I'm talking to you, I'm spending time with these guys. It gives them the opportunity to stay social with me. These two are in a cage with four other siblings, so there's six parrotlets. But you could see how tame they are. Yes, they were hand-fed. No, I don't have a lot of time to spend with them because I have other parrots, and these guys are little, so I don't like to let them out and let them fly around my house. It's much harder for me to have an open-door policy with these guys because I don't want them to get hurt, and it just would not take hardly anything from almost any of my other parrots to bite them, and I'm not okay with that. So, for that reason, I'm hoping the curtains behind me are gonna get replaced by a wall, and then this room is gonna be sealed off, and then I'll be able to do stuff like let some of my parrotlets out. When they're breeding, they don't want out. When they're breeding, they need to have like a nice, safe, secure environment. They need a nice, safe cage, but when you're trying to tame them, that's the very best thing you can do. I'm not gonna feed you, and I'm not gonna feed you out of my mouth, Carlos, you funny boy. Mwah. So, work with that. I would decide how sort of assertive I wanna be, how quickly I want for my parrotlet to get tamed. And if I really wanted to just go ahead and tame my parrotlet, especially if I only had one and he wasn't tamed, I would go ahead and I would probably all but zip tie the door open so that he could come out all the time. I would go ahead and get a glove or a stick. A stick probably won't work with a parrotlet. And I would take him out. I would clip the wings. And I have a video on how to clip. So if you need to learn how to clip, make sure to look that up because you can cut the wrong feathers and really injure or even kill your bird. So please make sure you look that up or take them to a pet shop that does clipping and they can clip it for you. And I would just keep my bird in my proximity. If they're on a perch near you, but you know, you're not in contact with them, they learn that it's safe, they learn that it's not a big deal, they learn that being around you is fine. Or if they're on your body, they quickly learn that it's all good, man. It's just all good. Not only is it all good, but that's my Pez dispenser or other treats, other foods. My parrotlets, I always teach them to eat fresh vegetables. They get fresh vegetables every morning. They like carrots. I give them the little Julian carrots, so it's small, so it's like their size. They love quinoa. They love red leaf lettuce. They like sweet potato, don't you guys? And with all parrots, the beta carotene is real good for them. So be a pest seed dispenser, share your food, share fun, share your space, and you will quickly tame your parrot if you are willing to do, you know, it just depends on how serious you want to be. If you don't want to clip, then in that case, I would bring my parrot out, I would close the door so they can't go back in, and just let them be around my house. They will come around. It'll take a little longer, but they will come around. Or if you're not clipping, put them on a harness. And then on the harness, you can keep them by you so that they can't fly too far, or on your shoulder, and they'll get it. And they do get it pretty quickly. All right, this has been my great blissful pleasure. Thank you for the question. We will catch you in the next Parrot Bliss video. And if I haven't already said so, check out my new products, my new parrot products that I'm designing. T-shirts and leggings and mugs and a journal so far. So please be sure to check out my merchandise. Maybe you'll need a gift for the holidays, and it helps me keep my parrotlets and everybody else in the flock.